Australian Survivor Blood versus Water has added a whole new element to the game. Loved ones sometimes have to vote each other out.
Yeah, last night Sophie found herself at the bottom of the blue tribe, which left her sister KJ in a fairly tricky spot.
Of course, I want to be loyal to Sophie, but
then your mind can't help but wonder, like, when she goes, I'm probably next on the chopping block.
It does put me in such a tricky position because I've got to be loyal also to my tribe because I'm going to need them to move forward in the game.
Seventh person voted out of Blood versus Water. Sophie, that's 5 votes. That's enough. You need to bring me your torch.
Gently just break my hand, squeeze my hand.
Stop being a big talk. Come on. This is your moment, OK? This is your big moment.
Go home and see your baby.
No, I'm going to look after your babies, OK? They're going to be so proud of Mama.
What an adorable way to exit as well. Sophie joins us now live from Melbourne. It's so nice to see you, Sophie. I tell you what, it is brutal in this game. Yesterday we saw, well, last night, night before, we saw a daughter vote out her mother, sister turned against sister. It's going to make for some very uncomfortable Christmas dinners, I feel. Was it hard watching it back last night?
Look, to be honest, no. When you're in that environment, like KJ just said on that clip then, you sometimes have to make moves to save yourself and get longevity for yourself. So KJ was very aware of the fact that if she didn't go with the majority and she didn't vote out her sister, that she'd absolutely be next. So I was aware of that. She was aware of that. And that was part of the game that we knew we entered with the blood versus water layer to it.
How much does having a loved one in the camp dial up the emotions in the competition?
Oh, it's insane. I think, you know, we've all been big fans of the show forever, but this complexity that having your family member brings, initially you think, oh, this is going to be great, it's going to be extra support, but it actually makes it harder because when you're on opposite tribes, you have to physically beat your loved one. If you win immunity, you are sending your loved one to tribal council. And then when you're on the same tribe, just because we're sisters, we didn't necessarily align with the same people. And in fact, we aligned with totally separate people, which made it really hard for us to work together. So from a perspective of a Survivor fan, KJ made the best decision she could have made last night. And as you can see, I was very, very smiley to exit the game at that point.
Oh, it was such a beautiful moment, the way you actually said goodbye to your sister and said you're going to look after her babies. I thought it was adorable. You were eliminated once already on the show, but you were thrown a lifeline. It's been quite a roller coaster. What was it like, kind of thinking it was over, then you're back again? Does that kind of mess your head up a little bit as well for the game?
Yeah, absolutely. And I, you know, I've seen a few comments on socials that I was too emotional for the game, and I won't apologise for that. But what people probably don't realise is I was blindsided. And in that moment, I thought, oh, I get to go home to my kids. And then I was taken back into the game. And then at the tribal, with the when Water went to tribal, I again thought I was going home. But then Alex unfortunately quit the game. So that was whiplash again of sort of logging out and logging back in. And Survivor's a very difficult game to log in and out of that much within the space of a few days. So I was mentally thrown. It was a lot harder than I could have ever possibly imagined. I think when you watch Survivor, you think, oh, how am I going to sleep on the sand? How am I going to eat rice? That is the easiest part of the whole game. So there is a whole mental layer to it that as a fan for my whole life, I probably wasn't prepared for.
Yeah, I was wondering that because, like you said, you were a huge fan of Survivor, as we all are. So on one side, it would have been a dream come true to play the game, but how do you prepare for that? Obviously, you can't prepare for the blind sides, but certainly living in the outback, everything else that comes along with Survivor.
Yeah, so, and I think that's probably a mistake that a lot of people make. You know, you try and make fire, you learn how to tie knots, and you get really fit. Physicality can only get you so far in this game, as I saw. I was probably, arguably, the strongest, if not up there with the women. That was instantly seen as a threat. But then I was a very vocal personality. I was very, you know, happy to show my emotions, and that was seen as a detriment. So I would say to anyone out there who is looking to apply for this season, concentrate on here before you think for applying, because we've seen time and time again that physicality, it will only get you so far. And if not, you're going to get picked off before merge anyway.
Yeah, you're a successful businesswoman. You've built an empire. Your pyjamas are still the comfiest in my cupboard. So what kind of skills do you think that work has that you could transfer to the game of Survivor. Did that help, that kind of business acumen?
Yeah, and again, look, you see, the reality is you see a one-hour episode over 3 days. So there's obviously lots of footage you don't see, and something that you wouldn't have seen from me is when I got the blind side, and it comes from my business knowledge, we have to make really difficult decisions every single day and we have to move on really quickly. Mm. So that's something I actually did. I moved on really quickly from that. I offered a lot of people, hey, clean slate, start again, you know, fresh start. But a lot of other people aren't able to do that. So I was really unfortunate that, you know, time and time again, I forgave people that had double-crossed me and I thought, well, hey, this is a fresh start, let's work together. And I think that comes from my business background of just, you know, get on with life, you get on with it and you find a solution and you don't talk about it again. So that helped me to an extent, but it didn't help me when other people didn't want to do that as well.
Yeah. Sophie, who do you want to see win the game? Who has the minerals?
Oh, absolutely, my sister KJ. And I'm really glad that Australia is starting to see her potential. And she showed that last night, willing to cut her little sister out. She's incredibly smart. She knows a lot more about this game. And what I found really interesting is when I got to the Water Tribe, how much of an incredible social game she was playing. She wanted to be underestimated. She wanted to be seen as the weak mum of three. And she's playing that role perfectly. So obviously my beautiful sister. But if I had to say someone else, I would go with the likes of Benny or Josh.
Oh, Australian Survivor, Blood versus Water continues tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Sophie, you were an epic player. Thank you so much for joining us. Oh, and how were those baby cuddles when you got home?
Oh, my goodness. I'm sure you can imagine, Sarah, they were just divine. Oh. And I said to my son, I'm never leaving you again. And then when I had to go back to work, he goes, I thought you said you were never leaving me again.
Can we don't they?
No, I'm never going on Survivor again.
Well, you did great. I'm sure they'd be very proud of Mum. Well done, Sophie. Thanks again.
Thank you, guys. Bye.
Take care.
Bye.